Okay, so what we've got here is Gypcrete, and we pulled out tile with the chip roto hammer. It just came out in chunks, just big, big chunks everywhere. So what we're gonna do is primer it, fill it in with patch, sanded patch up to 2 inches deep. Then we're gonna let that dry, and then we're gonna pour self-leveling over the top of that. Let that dry, and then we're gonna put the custom Crackbuster Pro membrane over the top of that. And then we're gonna put our tile over the top of that. And we're gonna hope not to be the ones to have to tear it out 8 years from now. Right?
We're praying that that's not us.
Because it is gonna be
brutal.
Yeah, they're gonna probably have to re-pour Gypcrete. You can see over here where the drain is at and water dripped out. It's just all powder because you got your Gypcrete floor. I mean, it's just powder. It's just a bad, bad substrate for tile. Works for carpet though.
You gotta get the substrate dust free, as clean as you can, so we have to vacuum it really, really good.
The hole is so deep over here, we had to do like a quick crete. It's probably, what, about 2 inches deep, three inches deep?
2.5 at least.
Yeah. So we got your primer. It's about a 50-50 water primer mix. And you gotta primer this Gypcrete after you vacuum it. Put it on real
thick.
Real thick, yeah. Because the Gypcrete's just gonna soak it up. And the primer will help the patch to bond, but it also prevents some of the moisture from getting into the... Okay, we're getting it all floated here. And this fills in all the pits, not all of them, it fills in a lot of pits. We still got more stuff there. And then we let it dry. You can see we started over here, worked this way. And then we're gonna do our self-leveling product over here. 50-pound bags, and we'll pour it on there. Okay, so we're primering the first coat. It's all dry now, ready to go. Getting it primered, getting ready for the self-leveling mix and installation. Okay, so you want to mix this to this consistency. Keep going. Okay, go ahead. So we're gonna just pour it, just easy. Just pour it towards the center there, that's good. Just kind of move it to the left. Just pour the whole thing, kind of move it back to the right over here. Okay, we're gonna mix several of these buckets. See how it's washing over there, and then it's getting up towards the wall. See how it's moving towards the wall there.
Yeah, how it's kind of spreading out.
Yeah, so this is going to seek its own level. Go ahead and go get another thing there. And then, so what we're going to do is get our squeegee. So you just want to take your squeegee and kind of move it around a little bit.
My goal is, like, this side is going towards the mercury.
Okay.
This side I want to sconce. Yeah. And it'll be beautiful. And I don't even want gold. Even though gold would look pretty good.
Okay, and we're gonna kind of pull it back here. It should seek its own level, but this kind of pushes it and ushers it along a little bit.
Let's see.
that corner's kind of a low spot, huh?
Yeah. You see, now it's gonna start flowing out this way. We're full back there. One more might do it. Give me 5 quarts of water.
All right, here's 8 bags. 8 bags worth. So right here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna marry these two together with a feather finish. It's a Portland cement based patch. So we'll just feather that off, run a primer, put the feather finish on there, and then we're gonna coat it with this membrane. Okay, so we're done loading the floor here. And it is, it's very, very smooth. I mean, compared to what we had yesterday, very smooth. So that took 8 50-pound bags of self-leveler and 4 25-pound bags of patch that we originally floated in the cracks and crevices with. Okay, this is the primer product that we're using. It's made by Custom Building Products, and we are also... Okay, we're putting our primer on, and the surface here has a tendency to get a little dusty, although this is a very clean surface, but the primer kind of seals the surface and enables the membrane to make a better bond. Okay, our primer's all dry. It didn't take very long for it to dry. This is the product that we're gonna be using, the Crack Buster Pro by Custom Building Products. Comes in rolls, comes in with a wax paper, and then this is very, very sticky. Okay, we've got it all cut in. And now we're ready to start peeling it and putting it in the floor. Okay, so you just peel that back.
Cut it off.
Get it in place.
Don't let it touch itself. Yeah, it becomes one with itself right away.
Okay. You want me to pull on that while you roll it in?
Well, this first one, we don't, one guy can do the first one.
It's a two-guy job, yeah. Right?
Yeah, this, when we go to run them together, yeah, we want to keep them nice and tight together.
Make sure you don't go too fast and get lumps in there. Just let it fall little by little. Wipe it down, you're done, because that's super sticky. Okay, all ready to start doing our layout. Set the tile, it's all in now. So this is the finished product with all the self-leveling and everything that we did. Turned out pretty nice.